My name is Fraser Cain. I'm the publisher of Universe Today. My daughter is a question-asking machine, and she came with this puzzler when she was just 6 years old. What is the biggest star in the universe? My answer was that the universe is a big place, and we can't possibly know what the biggest star is. But that's not a real answer. So I did some research to learn what the biggest star is that we know of, and just how big a star can get, theoretically. Let's consider our own sun for a sense of scale. The sun measures 700,000 kilometers from the center to its surface. This distance is known as a solar radius. The mass of the sun is 2 times 10 to the power of 30 kilograms, and this is what we call one solar mass. We use a solar mass and a solar radius to give us relative terms to describe the size of other stars in our universe, and this makes it easier for us to wrap our heads around just how incomprehensibly gigantic these things are. When we think of big stars, they're both massive stars and large stars. Astronomers theorize that the most massive star you could possibly get is 150 solar masses, or 150 times the mass of our sun. And they would have only existed in the early universe when stars were made of pure hydrogen and helium and trace metals left over from the Big Bang. The most massive star that we currently know of is R136A1. This star is located in the Large Magellanic Clouds Tarantula Nebula, 165,000 light years from Earth. And here's the best part. This star is more than 265 solar masses, breaking the original theoretical limit. So what's going on? Scientists believe it was likely created when several supermassive stars merged together. They predict that R136A1 is soon nearing the end of its life, and when it does, it will become a hypernova, one of the most powerful explosions in the universe, and collapse into a black hole. Another massive star located closer to Earth is Eta Carinae, only 7,500 light years away. The radius of Eta Carinae is about 250 times the size of the Sun and contains about 120 solar masses. It produces a million times as much energy as the Sun and is expected to explode as a supernova any day now. But there are much bigger stars out there, less massive, but bigger. Betelgeuse and Orion is a red supergiant star nearing the end of its life, has a radius of 950 to 1200 times the size of the Sun. If there was some way to magically summon Betelgeuse to the center of our solar system, all of the inner planets, as well as Jupiter, would be orbiting inside it. There's some controversy, but the biggest known star is VY Canis Majoris, a monster located 3,900 light years away. Good thing it's so far away, because it's huge. It measures 1,300 to 1,540 times wider than the Sun, and if it was located in the solar system, it would engulf the orbit of Saturn. We can't see and measure every star in the universe. So what's the biggest possible star? According to Roberta Humphreys from the University of Minnesota, the researcher who calculated the size of VY Canis Majoris, the largest possible star is about 2,600 times the size of the Sun. Stars that big are out there somewhere. If you want more space news, subscribe to our channel or visit our website at universetoday.com. Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching. Now make sure you click subscribe on our YouTube channel over here. And maybe you've still got some questions about space and astronomy, like this one or that one. And if you don't see the question you're looking for, then send me an email at info@universetoday.com.